Hi, my name is Shauna Moses. I am Associate Executive Director at the New Jersey Association of Mental Health and Addiction Agencies, or NJAMHAA, which is a trade association representing providers of services. And this is my dog, Chica. And I started working at NJAMHAA after losing a very close relative to suicide. And that was a way for me to give back to the community of providers who had helped this very close person in my life, and I learned a lot more about mental health and had the passion to help in the cause. And I have my own stronger personal commitment since having had experienced my own depression, and still have depression, and having had a suicidal experience myself. Through my volunteer work with Attitudes in Reverse, where we educate students about mental health and suicide prevention, through that I learned that depression or other mental illnesses have a biological basis. There's a chemical imbalance in the brain, and there's also a trigger. So that clicked in my head that the trigger had to have been the death of this very close relative of mine, and I was diagnosed with depression shortly after that. My very, very intense chronic depression leading to the suicide attempt actually didn't happen until more recently, about 3.5 years ago, when life just became very overwhelming for a lot of different reasons. Work was very overwhelming. My whole life was work. No social life to break it up. And the way my brain worked, which I guess has to do with the depression, is that I dwelled on a lot of other negatives in my life, and I wasn't able to focus on the positive. So I dwelled on the fact that I had 2 divorces. I dwelled on the fact that I had multiple failed relationships besides the marriages. And the way my brain was, hey, might as well dwell on the fact that I've lost a loved one in my life. And that was such a shock to my system. And although that happened years before, it became a more prominent thought in my mind. And all of those thoughts just overshadowed everything else in my life. And I've always had a lot of positives in my life, my son, my family, my friends, but the negatives were just taking over. I remember thinking, if I can't be happy about the good things in my life, and at the time I thought I never would be happy, what was the point of living? So the thought of suicide took over, and that was very, very scary. And my escape, for the most part, when I was very depressed, was to sleep. We can only sleep so much. And I would sleep entire weekends, and I would make up excuses to my son. You know, I have a stomachache or I have a headache. I would never say I was depressed. I got to a point where that thought of suicide just would not stop. It was like a monster taking over. And I left the apartment because my son was home, and drove somewhere, and I did attempt suicide. Fortunately, I was not effective at it at all. At the time, I was frustrated about it, and fortunately, a little bit of rational thought broke through, because severe depression just makes you very irrational. I finally realized I need to stop doing this, and I need to get some help. And I knew where I wanted to go. Fortunately, I knew where to go because of my work at the trade association, and the next day, that's where I went. It's Carrier Clinic, it's an inpatient unit, was there for a few days. It's amazing what can be done in a few days. I know for some people it could take longer, it's different for everybody. But since then, I've been on antidepressant medication, still am 3.5 years later. Still, I've been in therapy kind of off and on, back in it now. Recommend any kind of treatment that works. It's different for everybody, whether it's medication or the different kinds of therapy that are out there. And also my involvement with air and my dog, of course. I remember my dog. They're both very therapeutic. When I can take off from my job, I join Attitudes in Reverse, or AIR, for school presentations. I share that story that I just told all of you with the students. And I share it because I want to show that a lot of people go through the dark times. And it doesn't have to be a death sentence. We do hear about suicide, unfortunately, every day, it seems. And there are probably even more suicides than what we're hearing about. But it can be prevented. In many, many cases, mental illness is highly treatable. And I'm one of those examples. I do still have my very dark days, but they're so rare compared to before I went into Carrier and started on medication. Sometimes I do need to sleep in for an entire day. But the only thought of suicide I have now is about preventing it from happening for other people. I don't have any thoughts about ending my own life now, honestly. And I'm not just saying that because I'm on camera.